Hello everyone, this is Rudri Pathak from Department of Pharmaceutical Technology, LJ Institute of Pharmacy, Ahmedabad. Welcome to the online MOOC lecture series, an initiative taken by LJ Institute of Pharmacy, a part of LJ Group of Institutes. In today's session, we are going to talk about a very interesting topic, and that is eutectic mixtures. It is included in States of Matter, BPharm Semester 3, subject of physical pharmacy. So let's begin with the definition of eutectic mixtures. So what do we mean by eutectic mixtures and why it has become an integral part of pre-formulation studies? That is, before deciding any particular formulation, we need to look for the probabilities or possibilities whether that particular formulation is exhibiting eutectic mixture-like properties or not. So it is defined as a mixture of two or more components which do not interact or react chemically, but in a certain ratio or at a particular temperature, they behave as a liquid. So imagine we are having two solids which come in close proximity to each other, and because of some changes or alterations in their physical properties, they result into a third compound which is behaving like a liquid and not a mixture of solids. Okay, and that happens because the resulting compound or resulting material is having a different melting point, which is usually lower than both the compounds, compound A and compound B. So this is a particular phenomena which is not because of the chemical alterations in product A and product B or compound A and compound B, but this is a physical phenomena which happens when two certain materials comes in close contact with each other. So what are the conditions in which eutectic mixtures are actually prepared, or what are the situations in which they behave in such a manner? So first of all, they must be miscible in liquid state and they are immiscible in solid state. Say for example, if you are keeping them, both of them separately, both the compounds are behaving like a solids separately. So they are not miscible or they are not going to mix or interact when they are in the solid state. But the moment you keep the compounds in close contact with each other, they will be forming a miscible third compound which looks like a single phase, and it appears as if it never had two different states. Okay, and they should be in intimate contact, that means they should be in close proximity with each other so that melting point depression can actually occur and a resulting compound can be formed which is having lower melting point than the original ones. Okay, and they should have certain chemical groups which induces temporary bonding. It is not a permanent phenomena, but both the compounds, compound A and compound B, which we are imagining right now, they should have certain chemical structures so that they can have a temporary bonding or this resulting phenomena which we are going to talk about. Okay, what are the applications of studying such kind of mixtures as a part of, as I already told you, it is a very important part of pre-formulation studies. So it helps us in estimating incompatibility or compatibility studies between two or more APIs. If the formulation is having more than one API, then it is used or utilized to study how those APIs are going to interact. Then it is the study between APIs and excipients. If we are using excipients, lots of excipients, and it is used to check whether there is a probability that they can be converted into a eutectic mixture. Because imagine the solids will be having a different property, and if it is resulting into a eutectic like compound, then the properties will be altered, not just for the formulation, but also the pharmacological effects will be altered. So it is used to study before deciding the possible dosage form or selection of those ingredients. Then, as I talked about, it is also used in designing the drug delivery formulation or it is also used in designing what kind of formulation will be feasible if at all I'm having a eutectic mixture and I still want to work on that, then what are the possible ways in which I can reduce the chances of that formulation getting converted into a liquid state. So that helps in deciding what kind of formulation should be there, how the excipients should be separated from each other so that they do not get converted into a liquid formulation. Then we have a classical example of thymol and sialol. Why I am discussing this? Because this is very important if you are preparing for entrance examination. If you look at any eutectic mixture chart, you will get the same representation that is right now in the shown in the graphical representation in the PowerPoint. The graph will be divided into four segments. Okay, the first segment, which is shown by two parallel lines, which is shown at the bottommost part of the graphical representation, represents solid sialol and solid thymol, which is our example in this case. Then there are two triangles, which represents solid sialol and a mixture of both the components, and the other triangle represents solid thymol and the complex mixture of thymol and sialol, which is existing in the eutectics. Then we have an area above these geometrical shapes, and that is known as liquid state, where no matter what the composition of thymol and sialol is, no matter what the temperature is, both of them are going to exist as a complex liquid, which is our eutectic mixture. So based on these presumptions, what we can have, if we know the composition of thymol and sialol, percentage weight by weight per se, then you can actually estimate at what temperature it is going to behave as a eutectic mixture and till what temperature it is going to remain in the solid state. The downmost point, which is shown by a yellow color dot, signifies it is the eutectic point, or the temperature at which it is going to behave in the minimum temperature at which it is going to behave as a eutectic mixture for a particular composition, which is shown by eutectic temperature, which is almost 13 degrees in the classical example of thymol and xenon. Then obviously we have two more yellow colored dots, which shows the melting points of thymols and xenol, respectively. Then there is one more classical example which I would like to talk in today's lecture, and what kind of formulations are actually available in the market which explores this particular property of being converted into a liquid state. So we could find only one formulation which is available in the market, and that is known as EMLA. And that is eutectic mixture of local anesthetics, which includes two anesthetics, which is given in the slide, that is lidocaine and prilocaine. So both the agents are local anesthetics, and when they get combined at a particular percentage weight by weight fraction, they gets converted into a eutectic mixture. And this particular formulation is utilized for giving anesthesia to children. And lidocaine and prilocaine is used in a ratio of 1:1 and administered to younger adults or children. So that's all for today's session. We talked about what is a eutectic mixture and what are the conditions in which eutectic mixture actually happens. What are the minimum requirements? Then what are the applications of studying eutectic mixture? We also talked about the graphical representation of sialol and thymol, which is a classical example. And then we talked about the pharmaceutical formulation, which is available in the market, which is based on this particular property that is converted into a eutectic mixture. Stay tuned for more such videos on our official channel, which is Pharma Ignite. I would like to repeat once again, please like, share, and subscribe our official channel for more such videos. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe.